Well, hey guys, obviously, I have a special guest on with me. It is your first time to be on a video blog.
It's the first time to be in this room.
Well, welcome. Does it feel wonderful and happy?
Oh, it's awesome.
Well, we try to make it.
It's a room full of happiness. Yeah.
So my dad's on today to give some advice to dads out there for Father's Day. Well, I've had every guest on. Christy's been on a couple times. You know, Chris Brown, Anthony. Mom has been on twice. Denise has been on twice. And how many times have you been on?
This would be the first.
Yes, yeah. Exactly. Just want to reiterate
that. Well, I haven't been invited, so there you go.
That might be true. You're kind of busy. I wanted to pull in my dad because Father's Day is coming up. It's just such a vital holiday that I think, you know, really to celebrate and uplift dads. So I want you to give dads out there three things that you did as a dad growing up that they can implement and that they should implement to raise wonderful kids.
To make a perfect child. Yeah, this is the recipe. Are you ready?
I'm kidding.
And humble. That's what you want them to be, humble, yeah. You know, before there was Meg Meeker, when you guys were born, I was working with the teenagers at the church, and I was reading a guy named Josh McDowell, and he was the first guy I ever read in the Christian space, or in any space for that matter, that talked about the importance of a dad's relationship, the importance of a dad's role. And he said this, and I told the parents of the teens this back then, that dads with daughters, you're either going to give your daughters hugs or somebody else will. Mm. And that includes teenage daughters.
Yeah.
And it's like awkward and weird and all that. And so, you know, physical affection from dad is a preemptive strike from having a promiscuous teenager. You know,
and
so, you know, I learned that kind of stuff. I didn't know that by any stretch. So we were real intentional about that with you guys as you were growing up. The other thing that Sharon and I started doing, we had read another book that this lady said to begin praying for your son's or daughter's future spouse when your son or daughter is born.
It's good.
And I remember one guy was dating one of my daughters, and he's like trying to get like this. And I said, dude, I've been praying for their spouse since they were born. You think you're that?
You're like, you're not who I was praying for.
Stiff arm. So, you know.
And that's not either one of our husbands today.
No, it's not. It's not. That's for sure.
That's good. Praying for the spouse.
In advance.
Yes. Yeah,
when your daughter or your son is born, start praying for their spouse. And, you know, I think moms are in charge of details. Dads are in charge of fun. It's like our category. We get to do stuff. I mean, like Rachel was in cheerleading, and she was the little cheerleader. So they would throw her, and she was the thrower?
Flyer.
The flyer. That's right. And so, so anyway, she would climb on the shoulders. So we're at the lake house. And the cousins are all down there. We're water skiing.
Yeah.
And we're like, okay, Rachel, you're the climber, the thrower, the flyer, whatever it is. You get up on top of it. And so we get out.
This is a very wounding story. I've had to go to counseling to get
over
this.
Four or five of us, get out there. We're water skiing. Rachel climbs up, and she's the one on the top, right? Until she decided she was falling.
No, he says this all the time. No, the waves hit, the cousin fell,
drama
and then I fell.
And dove. She drama queen, let go of the rope, dove, hit the ski, busted her head. I had to take her to the emergency room, get staples in her head. So her mother's mad. She's permanently wounded. Dads are in charge of fun. That's all I'm saying.
Craziness. The craziness of life. Because I do remember, like, even you coming home from work and, like, wrestling with, like just, like, playing with your kids and having fun and some adventures and, like,
my goal was to make Sharon afraid because I threw the baby too high.
That's right. Oh, my gosh. That's so good. So three main things for dads to remember. Physical affection is huge. Hug your kids. Love them that way. Pray for their spouse. Mm-hmm. Love that. Yes. And have fun. Enjoy. Be crazy, dads.
Be in charge
dads.
Of fun.
Be crazy. Okay. So now that you look back as a dad, because can we say your age? Mm-hmm. How old are you? Hold on. Let me guess.
We could say your age if you knew
You're 55.
29-year-old. Yes.
You're 55?
I'm 56. Thank you.
Year wiser than what
old.
I was expecting. Okay. So when you look back as a young dad, are there things you would advise dads out there that you didn't do that you're like, oh, that would have been a good place, you know, to do X, Y, and Z? Are there things that you look back on?
You know, I think I take a page out of Meg Meeker's stuff. Her job and what she talks about with dads is just to let them know their importance. Sometimes I thought, you know, maybe I'm in charge of fun, or maybe I'm in charge of prayer or physical affection or spiritual walk, or take them on a date night. We took you guys on date nights when you were little girls, yeah, and that kind of stuff. Not a bunch of times, but enough times that it registered
those
in your,
yeah,
brain,
totally,
you know, that you're important.
Yes.
You know, but I would just tell young dads what Meg tells them, and that's, mm-hmm, that you're important. Even though the culture says you're an idiot, even though the culture says dads doesn't matter, even though all that, just ignore all that and be right there in the middle of it and serve your family. Even if mom's pushing you away, saying, oh, leave him alone, leave him. No, I'm not leaving him alone. I'm getting on this. And if your gut instinct is probably better than you think it is.
It's good. You're important. I know, yeah. And that's even, we're like plugging Meg Meeker through this whole video blog, but it's just such good material, dads. She has a new book coming out, or it's out, is about hero.
Mm-hmm.
And just that word, too. I'm like, yes, elevating dads as you're the hero to your kids' lives. And I can speak from a daughter to that, and even watching Amelia with Winston, it's so true. That vital role that you play, and just looking at yourself as that.
And it's not mean, or it's not out of control or something, but there's something authoritative about dad's voice. I mean, you think about when you were growing up, when dad spoke. It's different than when mom spoke. And I don't know. I mean, it's not. You don't have to have Chris Hogan's voice to do it, right? You know. But when dad speaks, you know, there's something that's like, I said no. That's different than mommy going, I said no, quit doing it. You know, and it's just different, you know? It's,
yes,
like the hammer's getting ready to drop here.
Yes.
And it's not that moms don't discipline, dads discipline, that's not the point.
Right.
But there's just something authoritative about that. And don't discount the power of your presence or the power of your instincts when you're in the middle of that. And the other thing I can remember other than that is the babies and little children are more resilient and less fragile than everybody thinks they are. You know, everybody's like, you're going to break them, or you're going to screw this up. You're not going to screw it up. You know, their psyches don't break that easy. Their spiritual walk doesn't break that easy. Mm-hmm. They're resilient, and they physically don't break that easy. I mean, she had staples in her head. She's sitting here.
Yeah, I was going to say, you took me to the hospital.
Went to the hospital. Whoa. Like, every kid has to go to the emergency room. You're supposed to have a cut right here at some point in your life. Everyone is. They're harder to kill than you think they are.
Oh,
it just really is. It's
Enjoy.
Have fun with them, you know?
That's so good. Oh, gosh. Well, good advice out there. I love it. I love it. And I love, again, this idea of being able to celebrate you, Dad. So if you're a mom watching, send this on to your husband. Forward him the link and let him see, just to give him some encouragement. So, dads out there, happy Father's Day and some fun things. So,
yeah,
thanks for coming on.
Yeah, we're excited. Speaking of proud fathers, 3 national best-selling books now, because Graduate Survival Guide just made the bestseller list, and that means she's had 3 national bestsellers before she's 30. That's pretty stinking cool.
Telling
right there.
Telling everyone my age again.
That's pretty cool.
Thank
29
you.
And holding on tight. But there we go. Yeah, live it out, you know, as long as you can. But in the middle of all that, the Rachel Cruze Show is now going to happen.
Yes. And the first episode's out, so some of you guys may have seen. Yeah, so the second one actually comes out tomorrow. So if you go to rachelcruze.com, sign up for my newsletter to get all the deets. Do you know what deets means?
Details.
Oh, whoa.
I was guessing.
That was good. You are much younger in spirit than 56 years old, I have to say. So just sign up for the newsletter to get all the details of the second episode that's coming out soon. So it's actually coming out tomorrow. I'm pumped. So, happy Father's Day. Early Father's Day to you.
Thanks for
coming on. Love you, too. Oh, sweet. Okay, thanks. Oh, you got to give a high five. Everyone gives high fives.
Oh,
yeah, there you go.
Right.
Hey, guys. Thanks so much for watching this video. And again, happy early Father's Day to you dads out there. So, make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Get some more fun videos like this. And the Rachel Cruze Show, it's happening, y'all. I can't believe it. So, go to rachelcruze.com. Sign up for my newsletter there again to get all the details of where and when it's playing. So thanks, you guys. And again, happy early Father's Day.